Importing project data from Excel into PowerPoint with Office Timeline lets you quickly turn new sheets into beautiful timeline slides. However, you first need to set up your Excel sheet for importing. So let's start with that. At the very least, your sheet will need to have columns for milestone or task title, start date, and end date. Rows with both dates filled in will become tasks, while those with only one date filled in will become milestones. You can also add optional columns for swim lanes, sub-swim lanes, percentage complete, and notes. But maybe the most important column you can add is the row ID column. The row ID is a unique identifier for each of your tasks and milestones, which enables the refresh functionality for your import. This means that whenever you update or change the data in your Excel sheet, you will also be able to update any timeline you made through the Excel import feature from that sheet by clicking the refresh button over here. Once everything is formatted properly, you can move on to importing your Excel file. In PowerPoint, go to the Office Timeline ribbon. If you want to style your timeline from scratch, you can select Import and choose Microsoft Excel. But if you select the New tab, you can import data directly into a pre-existing template, meaning that most, if not all, of the styling work will be done automatically when you finish the import process. Moving forward, to get the data, we must first select our desired worksheet. Make sure that the right table header is selected, since this is important for the next step. Mapping the columns. Using the table header we selected earlier, Office Timeline automatically maps the columns for you. If, however, you wish to change or unmap any of them, you can do so by clicking on any of these headers. The final step is to select which rows you want to see on your slide. You can use the checkboxes next to each row to select or deselect individual tasks and milestones. If you have a complex project with lots of rows, you can also use the filter option to sift through them. Let's say you only want to see tasks and milestones that end before a specific date. Set the field to end date, the condition to is less than, and the condition value as the deadline. Then hit apply. Now you only see the rows whose end dates come before our chosen deadline. You can use the checkbox in the top left corner to simultaneously select all the rows in this current view. To clear a filter, go back to the filter menu and click on Clear Filter. Once you're done, click on Import. And there you go! Office Timeline has imported all our designated Excel data into the beautiful template we selected at the start of the process. Also, remember the row ID column from the beginning of the video? If there are any changes in the Excel file, having that row ID column in your sheet allows you to update your visual quickly and easily by clicking the refresh button here. That's it for this video, but if you want to learn more, don't forget to check out the Office Timeline Support Center. Thanks for watching!